Disarmament is the act of reducing, limiting, or abolishing weapons. Disarmament generally refers to a country's military or specific type of weaponry. Disarmament is often taken to mean total elimination of weapons of mass destruction, such as nuclear arms. General and complete disarmament was defined by the United Nations General Assembly as the elimination of all WMD, coupled with the balanced reduction of armed forces and conventional armaments, based on the principle of undiminished security of the parties with a view to promoting or enhancing stability at a lower military level, taking into account the need of all states to protect their security. History. Before World War I, at the Hague Peace Conferences in 1899 and 1907, government delegations debated about disarmament and the creation of an international court with binding powers. The court was considered necessary because it was understood that nation-states could not disarm into a vacuum. After the war, revulsion at the futility and tremendous cost of the war was widespread. A commonly held belief was that the cause of the war had been the escalating build-up of armaments in the previous half-century among the great powers. Although the Treaty of Versailles effectively disarmed Germany, a clause was inserted that called on all the great powers to likewise progressively disarm over a period of time. The newly formed League of Nations made this an explicit goal in the Covenant of the League, which committed its signatories to reduce armaments to the lowest point consistent with national safety and the enforcement by common action of international obligations. One of the earliest successful achievements in disarmament was obtained with the Washington Naval Treaty, signed by the governments of the United Kingdom, the United States, Japan, France, and Italy. It prevented the continued construction of capital ships and limited ships of other classification to under 10,000 tons displacement. The size of the three countries' navies was set at the ratio 5-5-3. In 1921, the Temporary Mixed Commission on Armaments was set up by the League of Nations to explore possibilities for disarmament. Proposals ranged from abolishing chemical warfare and strategic bombing to the limitation of more conventional weapons, such as tanks. A draft treaty was assembled in 1923 that made aggressive war illegal and bound the member states to defend victims of aggression by force, since the onus of responsibility would, in practice, be on the great powers of the League. It was vetoed by the British, who feared that this pledge would strain its own commitment to police the empire. A further commission in 1926, set up to explore the possibilities for the reduction of army size, met similar difficulties, prompting the French Foreign Minister Aristide Briand and U.S. Secretary of State Frank Kellogg to draft a treaty known as the Kellogg-Briand Pact, which denounced war of aggression. Although there were 65 signatories to the pact, it achieved nothing, as it set out no guidelines for action in the event of a war. A final attempt was made at the Geneva Disarmament Conference from 1932-37, chaired by former British Foreign Secretary Arthur Henderson. Germany demanded the revision of the Versailles Treaty and the granting of military parity with the other powers, while France was determined to keep Germany demilitarized for its own security. Meanwhile, the British and Americans were not willing to offer France security commitments in exchange for conciliation with Germany. The talks broke down in 1933, when Adolf Hitler withdrew Germany from the conference. Nuclear disarmament refers to both the act of reducing or eliminating nuclear weapons and to the end state of a nuclear-free world, in which nuclear weapons are completely eliminated. In the United Kingdom, the Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament held an inaugural public meeting at Central Hall, Westminster, on 17 February 1958. Attended by 5,000 people. After the meeting, a few hundred left to demonstrate at Downing Street. CND's declared policies were the unconditional renunciation of the use, production of or dependence upon nuclear weapons by Britain and the bringing about of a General Disarmament Convention. The first Aldermaston March was organized by the CND and took place at Easter 1958, when several thousand people marched for 4 days from Trafalgar Square, London, to the Atomic Weapons Research Establishment close to Aldermaston in Berkshire, England, to demonstrate their opposition to nuclear weapons. The Aldermaston marches continued into the late 1960s when tens of thousands of people took part in the four-day marches. In 1961, U.S. President John F. Kennedy gave a speech before the UN General Assembly where he announced the U.S. intention to challenge the Soviet Union, not to an arms race, but to a peace race, to advance together step by step, stage by stage, until general and complete disarmament has been achieved. He went on to call for a global general and complete disarmament, offering a rough outline for how this could be accomplished. There have been many large anti-nuclear demonstrations and protests. On June 12, 1982, 1 million people demonstrated in New York City's Central Park against nuclear weapons and for an end to the Cold War arms race. It was the largest anti-nuclear protest and the largest political demonstration in American history. Disarmament conferences and treaties. 1899, Hague Peace Conference. 1932-34, World Disarmament Conference. 1960, Ten Nation Disarmament Committee. 1962-1968, 18 Nation Disarmament Committee. 1969-1978, Conference of the Committee on Disarmament. 1979-present, Conference on Disarmament. Naval 1908-1909, London Naval Conference, 1921-1922, Washington Naval Conference, 1927, Geneva Naval Conference, 1930, London Naval Conference leading to the London Naval Treaty, 1935, London Naval Conference leading to the Second London Naval Treaty. Definitions of disarmament. In his definition of disarmament, David Carlton writes in the Oxford University Press Political Dictionary, but confidence in such measures of arms control, especially when unaccompanied by extensive means of verification, has not been strengthened by the revelation that the Soviet Union in its last years successfully concealed consistent and systematic cheating on its obligations under the Biological Weapons Convention. He also notes, now a freeze or a mutually agreed increase is not strictly speaking disarmament at all, and such measures may not even be intended to be a first step towards any kind of reduction or abolition, for the aim may simply be to promote stability in force structures. Hence a new term to cover such cases has become fashionable since the 1960s, namely, arms control. The book by Seymour Melman, Inspection for Disarmament, addresses various problems related to the problem of inspection for disarmament, evasion teams, and capabilities and limitations of aerial inspection. Gradually, as the idea of arms control displaced the idea of disarmament, the weaknesses of the present arms control paradigm have created problems for the idea of disarmament itself.